What is up, everybody? Lines on Paper here, and it looks like we know the official rating for the Justice League Snyder Cut release that's going to be coming to HBO Max, and we are going to be talking about that. But first, we got to talk about my latest comic. It is up funding right now on Indiegogo, Malevolent Rising 4. As I refreshed it, we've got some more backers overnight. So please give this a check, and hopefully consider backing it. Anyway, back to our review. So Justice League gets a rating, and what is that rating? That rating is R. This is an R-rated superhero movie, and I don't know how I feel about that. This movie seems to be a question wrapped in a riddle, smothered in an enigma, and covered in sauce. I mean, you know, I hear reports that it's going to be released in black and white. I hear reports that it's over 3.5 hours long. I'm not opposed to any, well, I don't like the black and white thing personally. I think, especially when you're dealing with the Justice League, I mean, you want the visuals to be as engaging as possible. And I think black and white has its limits, whereas color, especially on televisions today, can do a lot more. But the R rating, though, what do we think about that? On one hand, I have always said I enjoy when superheroes take a more mature tone. I think that they are definitely a genre that can be spoken to for different audiences. I said that when I did my review way back in the day for the Batman Black Label, where they had the nudity quote unquote issue in the first book. But you know what I say? At the time, the most popular TV on or show on TV was Game of Thrones. And if comic books are going to compete with today's streaming market and today's entertainment, then they're going to have to be able to cater to every audience out there. And part of that audience is people that want to see more sophisticated stories that go places that traditional comics maybe won't. And maybe that's what this movie's going to do. This is an R rating is going to allow the Justice League to explore maybe territory and themes that, say, the MCU and the Avengers movie never could. But at the same time, is that going to make it inaccessible for the people who you want to watch your movie, i.e., parents with kids 15 and younger? So I don't know. I mean, I'm rooting for this movie to succeed because I want the DCEU to take off and be, you know, as favorable as or as favored as the Marvel MCU someday, especially since with the current slate of movies at the time of this recording, I don't have a lot of faith in the MCU now or in the future of the MCU. That being said, WandaVision is already blowing me away. So they've given me a bit of faith, but I don't care about the Eternals. I don't care about Shang-Chi. They're bringing some D-list characters out. And, you know, a lot of people said that about the Guardians of the Galaxy, and look how great they turned out to be. So I'm obviously going to be going in with an open mind, but, you know, I'm not as excited as when I hear things like the next Avengers or Iron Man or something like that is on the horizon. So we'll have to wait and see. And I was kind of hoping that maybe this would be an opportunity for the DCU to step up and maybe find its place in the media market. And maybe an R-rated movie is going to be the way to do so. I mean, works for Deadpool, but Deadpool's not the Justice League. Deadpool's not a four-color hero that, you know, or four-color hero team featuring Superman, Wonder Woman, and Batman, who are traditionally thought of as pretty family-friendly characters. I mean, you know, obviously Batman tends to be a bit darker and more violent, and definitely I could see him having an R rating. But I mean, at the same time, you ask any 6-year-old who their favorite superhero is, and I would bet at least half of them are going to say Batman. So I don't know. Good move, bad move? Let me know in the comments. Let's discuss this. What are you looking forward to with the Justice League Snyder Cut? Are you looking forward to the Snyder Cut? Is this something that you feel kind of falls into the category of nope, reboot, we've seen it before, move on, make something new, just start over? Or are you happy to see that a lot of the fans that were crying out for the Snyder Cut to be released are going to get what they want? I personally think it's smart of HBO to actually listen to the fans as they're trying to build this mammoth streaming service and give them what they want. So let's discuss in the comments below. And please, while you're there, like and subscribe. And if you like what we're doing, I do have a Patreon account. It's linked on my Facebook or my YouTube channel. Please check that out. And again, Malevolent Rising issue 4, currently funding on Indiegogo. Please give that a look. And I will talk to you next time. Thanks again. Bye.